To follow along, download projects and footage from our training area at borisfx.com. Hi and welcome to the second part of the Composting in Vegas Pro tutorial. In this section, we will continue to work on the shot, starting by tidying it up with some cleanup and then polishing it by adding a flare on the top. This is where we left off in the first part. To continue working on the shot, let us get back to Mocha. I would temporarily disable visibility for all of the layers we have so far and put them in a separate folder. As I said in the first part, I want to remove this hatch, make the grass look more consistent, and clean up stuff on this wall. Let's start with the grass first. I grab X-Spline tool and draw a big shape around this whole ground area, avoiding the walls and the trash can. I draw the spline right where the lawn ends. Then I set my surface with the help of grid. And to stay organized, I change the spline color to green and call that layer grass. I track it backward with the default track motion options, and all seems to look good to me. After the track is finished, I can readjust this corner of the spline like this. We will use this layer as a mask for the patch later on. Now let's figure out the wall. There are quite some stuff that I want to remove. Ideally, these two areas should be tracked as two separate planes on a separate layers, because this part is slightly deeper and these columns are in the front. But to simplify the process and not to create too many layers in my project, I would track it with just one layer. I start with drawing my first spline around these beams, and then with the Add X-Spline tool, I create a few more shapes around the areas that I want to clean up. All of these shapes share the same layer. I would change its color to yellow and call it wall. Before I start to track the wall, I would disable the gear icon for the grass layer, as we've already tracked it. Then I set the surface to check how my track would look and track it forward. Right before the wall goes completely out of frame, I would change my track motion options and leave only the translation. That would give Mocha a hand and keep our track good enough when there's not enough information to track. Then I continue to track forward till I can. We got an error that Mocha is no longer able to continue to track, but that's fine, we can set the out point for this layer right on this frame. Now that we know that our track looks good for both of these layers, I would prep my project in a way to later use this track data over the clean plates. I've demonstrated this technique in a previous episode of this series, so if you missed that, I recommend checking it out first. So what I'll do now is I expand my surface on the frame where the wall is most visible, that is the first frame. For that, I click here. And then I scrap to the end of the clip where I can fully see the ground and do the same thing for the grass layer. That is selected, so I hit expand. Now everything is set up for the further work and we can return to Vegas. Once you're back, you may be surprised with what you see in the viewer. But don't be scared, we just need to toggle on the visibility back for the correct layers. That would be all of the layers that we have inside the mat folder, except the fence. And I would disable the visibility for the grass and for the wall. Hit OK, and we are back to normal. You may notice that I already have my clean plates inside the project media, but let's go over how I made them. I would temporarily disable Mocha effect on my main clip layer, and then use Vega snapshot feature to save the very first frame of the clip that we will turn into a wall clean plate, and also the very last frame that we need for the ground. In the previous video, we completed the work entirely within Vegas. However, this time, we have to do it somewhere else, so I brought these two images into Photoshop. If you have access to Photoshop's generative fill feature, you can remove stuff with it. But if you don't, you still can do the work in a more traditional way with tools like Clone Stamp. By the way, these two finished plates are also available inside the project archive, so make sure to check the link in the description. Once I painted both of my frames, I bring them back into Vegas and add them to the timeline. Now we need to apply both Mocha track data and masks to each of these clean plates. And here's the easiest way to do it. Select your main clip that has Mocha effect on it and hit Ctrl-C on your keyboard to copy it to the buffer. Then select both of your clean plates, right-click, and in the context menu, choose to paste event attributes. Now Mocha effect has been copied to both of these events with all the data and shapes we need. We just need to set up it properly. Let me mute the top track for now and work only with the wall clean plate first. I go to the event effects of the wall plate, and here we have the Mocha effect that we've copied from the main clip. In the matte menu, I have to disable the visibility for all of the layers except the one we're interested in. And then I hit create masks to export it as Vegas Bezier masks. We have no more than 5 shapes on this layer, so it's fine to export them as Bezier. The effect has been added to the chain, and now if I solo this layer, it should look like this. Optionally, you can add some feathering to each mask to avoid sharp visible edges. Here I do it for the first shape, and then repeat it for all the rest. Now we need to make this stuff move. For that, I would go back to the Mocha effect on my main clip, generate the data for the wall layer, and then apply it over the corresponding clean plate. This is the one called Clean Plate 1. I choose Picture in Picture effect, and we can close these windows. The steps may look almost identical to the one we did in the car remove video, however, they are not exactly the same. If I hit play, our result in the viewer would look kinda weird. That's because this time we are using animated masks exported from Mocha, and they've been applied before picture-in-picture effect, which makes our plate move. That's why the result appears incorrect. Fortunately, the fix is quite simple. We just need to swap the order of these effects. Now everything looks correct. The exact same steps should be repeated for the second plate, with the only difference that this time I would create a mask and generate the data for the grass layer. The motion data should be applied to clean plate number 2. And don't forget to set the correct order of the effects at the end. Now that I've done this to the both plates, the shot looks much cleaner. Finally, to put a cherry on the top of the cake, I want to add a flare on the top of my comp using the BCC lens flare effect. But how exactly do I apply it? I want the flare to overlay my entire composite, but I cannot just drag it onto my top layer because that's my ground clean plate and it won't look right at all. At the same time, I want the flare to be animated and follow the motion of the clip. So how do I make it work? Here's the trick. I would solo my source clip layer and temporarily add BCC lens flare effect to it. The plan is to set up the flare on my original footage first and then copy-paste the effect to be on the top of everything afterwards. There are tons of pre-made presets available inside BCC lens flare, and to pick one of them, just reach to the effect editor. The new window appears, and from here you can browse the library and pick the one you like. I'll stick with the one called Stylized 85. If you like the overall look of the flare but want to tweak individual elements, you can do so by clicking on the Edit Flare button, and here you can tweak each element one by one. I want to make my main hotspot a bit brighter to emulate the sun, so I click on the disk element, and here I can increase the brightness. When you're done tweaking, just close the effects editor. Now let's animate it. The Mocha parameter tracking is integrated right inside the BCC lens flare effect. Click on this button to launch it, and the new instance of Mocha will appear. Here we already have a pre-created shape that we should use for the tracking. The same as we did for the sky, we need to track some point in the distance. So I'll place this circle shape on the high contrast corner of the roof and track it both ways. As for the position marker, it would define the center of our flare. I want to emulate the sun, but I do not want it to actually be in the frame. So I will place it somewhere over here. Now that it's set up, I can close Mocha. And here we have our animated flare. The only thing left is to somehow place it at the top of the comp. We need to use some sort of placeholder where we can copy our effector. Here's what we can do. In the Media Generator tab, I search for a solid color and add a black one above all the layers. Then I select my main clip that contains BCC lens flare, hit Ctrl-C to copy it, and now I can safely delete the effect from this event. Then I right-click on the black solid on my timeline and choose to paste event attributes over it. Now when I unsolo the source clip track, we should have the exact same flare but on a black background. If you've ever used any kind of overlays before, you know where I'm going with it. I would change the compositing mode of the top track from source alpha to screen, and now the flare would be overlaid over the entire composite. Now we just need to bring back the sky by re-enabling the mocha effect on my main clip. So I turn it back on here, and let's take a look at our final result. Now you should have a clear sense of the creative freedom you gain by having a tool like Mocha right inside Vegas. Grab a free project from our website or experiment with your own clips to try it out for yourself. If you found this helpful, please give us a like and leave a comment. That will let us know that we should make more of this. My name is Elizabeth Postel for Boris Facts. Bye for now!